Let's talk for a moment on retail packaging of trading cards and how it comes out of the factory and how it was developed over the years. The most acceptable format of trading cards was the wax pack. What it was either that or a bubble gum pack, it was called. And the reason why it was called a wax pack or a bubble gum pack is there was a wax coating and it was used to seal the cards. Or some people called it a bubble gum pack, and the reason why is because it contained a piece of bubble gum inside with the trading cards. You'd open it up and get 15 trading cards, and approximately, and you'd collect either your favorite team or your favorite player, or the advanced collector. If you turn them over, they would be individually numbered. And you would put them in numerical order and hopefully kept open enough packs to be able to complete the complete set. Over the years, the wax packs went away, and what happened is they developed what they thought was better was the foil pack. And it would open from the back just like the wax pack, but it would be made out of a foil material, and you could just rip it open and open it up. And if you notice, it's kind of foily there, and it would contain your trading cards in there. Some retailers wanted a higher price point product, so what they developed is they developed what's called a rack pack, and it contains three different packs, and since it had three, it would have a higher price point than the individual wax or foil pack. There was also what was called a blister pack, and they would put some packs of cards, two or three or whatever they had, and then they would blister it to a piece of cardboard, and then it would hung on a retailer shelf like that. However you want to collect them, wax packs and foil packs are fun to open, and if you want to visit our website for more information, you can go to Cards One.